Hello friends, Sentinel H here, and welcome back to Planetbase. So, we lower our roofs, we can get started. So if you remember, at the end of last episode, we invited over another group of visitors. And these visitors are in need of the same thing the last visitors were. Water, sleep, and a new thing, which is morale. So they're not doing so hot on their morale, and so they need some sleep. And in exchange, interestingly enough, a permanent boost to prestige, which is quite interesting. So these guys are going to be these purple visitors are going to be wandering around and sleeping, and this guy's going to bed. Various things happening, which is pretty cool. I want to increase the effectiveness of this radio antenna to intercept transmissions. Whoa. Why is power storage going down instead of up? We're overloaded during the day? This is not good. We can't be overloaded during the day. Where's the solar panels? Build it now, guys. Seriously. Alright. It looks like we didn't have enough solar power to charge the things ourselves. It requires at least a certain amount of wind power, which I don't like. You know, the wind power should be... The wind power is there mainly to help us at night. Drain our batteries a bit slower. Not to rely on for daytime charging. Daytime charging needs to be completely solar. It looks like we are charging now, but not nearly as fast as I'd like. This could take people a long time to bring the stuff over there, which is a problem. Alright, anyway, we need milestones. We have 4. I think I need 5 to unlock the next planet. Yeah, so we need to reach one of these milestones, and the easiest one to reach is robotization. Already have 8 bots. All we need is 2 more bots, and one of them is 48% complete. And our factory is set to build 10 bots. So all we have to do is survive until we build 2 more bots, and we will have our 5th milestone, which I do believe unlocks the next planet. This isn't charging fast enough. We're not going to have enough power for the night unless they build that solar panel fast, or unless the wind picks back up. I don't want to have to rely on a random sandstorm appearing at night in order to keep my base alive. It's not a good thing. Power management is definitely something I have to get better at. I need to keep the power generation ahead of power consumption. And that's not always so easy. Oh, it's because these signs actually take power. Does disabling them lower our prestige? No. But we can save a couple of bits of power by turning these signs off. It's not going to make much of a difference. That's filled up. Now what's charging? This one. Oh, come on, guys. Build it. There's still some time before the night time. Alright, well, the wind has picked up and it's helping. They have all the resources. Dude just needs to come out and build it. Where is he? We need an engineer to go over there. These guys are so lazy. There he is. Lorenzo is going to the airlock. By the time he gets there, it's probably going to be nighttime. Go and build it, you fool. We need power. Alright, well, at least, I mean, three of them are going to be full. I would want four to be full. Okay, that one's filled. Now this one's filling. What? He built the thing, but he didn't build the connection? Are you kidding me? Wow. What a guy. He didn't build the connection. Wow, I hate that guy. See you, Lorenzo, is now my least favorite person. How could he do that? Yeah, the AI in this game needs improvement. The dude who builds this should immediately build the connection. There's no excuse for him not building that connection after, right after he builds the solar panel, he should build the connection. That's unacceptable. Alright. Well, see you, Lorenzo is gonna have his rations docked. He's not gonna get paid as much. Because he has just gotten on my bad list. Right, so those dudes left, gave us some prestige. This guy's got money and then starch and ore, which we don't want to buy, obviously. But if we have anything we could sell, that would be nice. But we really don't, except for medical supplies. But now that we're accepting visitors, we really want our medical supplies. Because you never know when visitors are going to show up and need medical supplies. This could get very bad. We could very well run out of power. Because the wind is so unreliable. And we might not have enough power in reserve to last the night because of the solar. Okay, somebody just needs to come over here and work on this robot. Alright. Somebody told me that you could set priorities. I'm not sure how you're supposed to do that. I have not seen anywhere to do that. Oh, that's a nice chart. I don't know what it means. Ah, we can disable non-vital structures. What does that do? I suppose if we have a massive power shortage, we could always do that. Hey, someone built the connection. At night, when it's not going to do us any good. If you'd built that when you built the solar panel, it may have at least helped. I want someone to come over here and build this robot. I'd like to, like, prioritize this. Wow, dang, this thing uses a lot of power. I want to tell them, like, hey, come over here and operate this. I really wish you could command your people. This engineer is going to go over here and maintain this solar panel. Well, at least we've got wind going now, slowing this down a little bit. We'll make it to daytime probably. Well, what I can do is try out this button. It really does turn off everything except oxygen. Wow. I would consider the biodomes vital structures. Apparently the game doesn't. Ooh. Okay, enough wind power picked up for a moment to, or at least we generated some extra power, so we'll be good for the night. Oh, come on, I turned these off earlier. There's another thing. If you turn something off manually, that turn all on button, maybe don't let that turn it back on. I'm sure 3 power isn't going to be the difference between survival and death, but I turned them off and I warmed them up. Okay, this guy's actually building the robot. Excellent. Let's speed up time because we don't have all day. 96, 97, 98, 99, and there is our 9th robot. Now, they're bringing the new resources. There we go. The bot workshop has all the resources it needs. We're currently producing 459 power. We can get a milestone for producing 500 kilowatts. It's currently 387. You know what? We have the resources. It'd be nice if we had access to the Goliath ones, but if I just start building solar panels all over the place, or wherever I could fit them, that's the problem. We can't fit much in this place anymore. We could get Powermonger. I really can't fit anything anywhere. Except over here. Of course, that would block future expansion of the actual base, which is not what I want to do. So I guess we're not getting Powermonger. Why can't I fit another solar panel in this gap, in this area here? It should fit. I mean, I don't actually need this sign anymore. Because that prestige boost has effectively done what we did for that. And now I can fit another Goliath here. My reasons for building that should be pretty immediately clear. We don't get any of these signs anymore. If we can get to 500 power production, we can get a second milestone. Alright, is this robot being worked on? Indeed it is. It's at 33%, so hopefully that robot will be produced soon. What's this guy got? Oh yeah, it's the ore and starch dude again. Come on guys, send me something different. I don't need all this ore and starch. Alright. You're being crazy here. Now what I could do is sell some of this stuff, because I have tons of it. And then we'll grab some money. Alright. Power collectors are at full. Honestly, another power collector wouldn't go amiss. Come on, 46%. Dude just needs to get back to work over there. Look at that. That's just running all over the place. Having one airlock over here is not a good thing. If I get rid of this, I could probably stick another airlock in. It's the same problem we had down there. Well, that drained already, but actually we're halfway through the night, so that's not a problem. Come on, what's this robot? Hopefully, oh crap. This guy's integrity is, oh no, it's back up to excellent, but this guy's integrity is still on the low end. I can't have one of these robots dying before this one's finished, otherwise I'll have to make another robot before we get the milestone. And again, the dude that built the solar panel didn't build the connection. Wow. I'm starting to think that the people that are being sent on this mission aren't the best and the brightest. Like, they're sending people that they don't like, or that are stupid. Alright, I just need a dude to build this so we can get the milestone. Okay, they built the connection. Now the question is, how much power will we be producing today? And will it be 500? Probably not. We've got all these big old wind turbines. I should probably get rid of these two small ones and just put a big ones in. But that would cut apart some of our vital infrastructure. We're up to 421. If the wind picks up, it could push us to 500. If the wind picked up. We're getting really close to 500 kilowatts. Ah, the dude's working on the robot. Sweet. There's another trading ship. This guy is selling spares. We don't need to buy spares. We're good. We got a lot of resources we could sell. We've got 448 coins, which may or probably won't actually be enough to buy one of the really cool blueprints. So we're gonna trade another 125 creds. That'll definitely give us enough. We're currently producing 496. Come on, just get up to 500. Just get up to 500, you dudes. Come on. Oh, transmission. A ship containing a large group of spatial accident victims are asking for help. The visitor needs... Oh, there's irradiated people with broken limbs. They need medical food and whatever. Now, the question is, do I have enough... Oh, we got Powermonger! The question here is, do I have enough... We're gonna say yes, but do I have enough beds in my medical bay? Probably not. We're gonna have 4 beds in medical. We've reached Powermonger, guys. We're now generating a ton, quote, of power. Powermonger! I like to click those buttons. It gives me a nice screenshot material. Alright, well, we got the landing. The landing showed up. Now let's take stock of these people. They're all in... Wow, holy cow. I should not have accepted these people. I didn't know it was going to be so many. That's my bad. I shouldn't have said yes to that. Our medics are going to be working round the clock, and we've only, which isn't a problem, but we've only got, if they build it, 4 beds. Which means most of these peeps are just going to have to hang around. Now, the broken limb people, I'm not worried about, but the radiation people need to be the first ones treated, because radiation exposure is going to continuously drain their health. And if they die, that might be a problem for me. Since they're visitors, it might, I don't know, it'll lower my prestige or what. But they need to get to medical. Hopefully it works out. 77%, I just need somebody to work this stupid bot workshop. Can we build another med bay somewhere? Like if I build a big one? We can't put it there because it'll block connections. Medbase can only have one connection. Alright, well, they built the medical bed at least. These can only have one connection. I could probably stick it up here, but that would be way too far away from the other one. So yeah, I should have built a larger sick bay, but at least the radiation people are coming in first. Our medics can treat them with the medical supplies in the cabinet, and hopefully they won't die. No, dude, with the broken limb, don't go to the med bay. We need these radiation... Why are they eating food? They should have gone straight to the sick bay. Well, now if they die, I don't feel bad for them because they could have gone to the sick bay. Well, it looks like 2 of the visitors died. Of radiation because they didn't go to the sick bay right away. Alright, looks like this person's going, but there was another person of radiation that was even lower health. This person, they really don't care about their lives. I mean, he's almost dead from radiation and he's gonna go get a drink. Vodka ain't gonna save you, dude. This ain't Stalker. Vodka ain't gonna save you. Alright, well, our med bay appears to be cycling people out. Yeah, see, you died. You died on your way to get a drink. Because you didn't go to sick bay. Yeah, see? And now you've died to radiation as well. And this guy, Hassan Bergman, is going to die to radiation too. Because they didn't go to sick bay fast enough. They didn't beat the broken limb people to sick bay. We have enough medical supplies for all these people. They just aren't, you know, weren't able to get to the sick bay in time. We didn't have a big enough sick bay. I should have declined that transport. Come on, where's the dude with the bot workshop? I want to see if we have enough milestones to unlock the new place. I want to start a... Yeah, see, Bergman died. I knew he was going to die. Is this person going to die on the sickbed? Yep, that person died on the sickbed. And now the medics are unhappy. Well, you didn't treat him. He was laying there on the bed, and you didn't treat him. You should have treated him faster. You know? I know you're unhappy. You're unhappy because someone died under your care. You're a crappy medic. Come on, it's at 93%. Somebody just come and build this stupid robot. Oh, look what you know. Another trade ship. What do you got? You've got medical supplies. Ooh, I could actually use those. I'm not going to buy them, though. I mean, screw that. Our next base is going to need to be planned out much better. We're not going to get, probably the full reward for that visitors. Oh, great. It looks like they're all gone. Good. I don't want them here anymore. Are they about ready to leave? They're waiting for two more people to leave? Great. Get out of my base, you, like, radiation burn victims. Power storage is full. And we're feeling fine. Baby. Okay. Let's start planning our next base. Hey, we got robotization. I'm not going to click that one because it's just going to show the same view of our base. Yes, I am going to click on it because Ooh, that's a pretty nice view right there. Robotization will improve the efficiency of your colony. Indeed, robots are great. We need to get TARS. We need to build TARS. We'll get a couple TARS units. That'll be fantastic, right? Okay, so we've gotten 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm pretty sure all I needed was 5 to unlock the next, base location. Megalomania. We're not reaching 300 pop, that's for sure. That's not happening. The space is not optimized at all. There's not enough space. Expanding into this area is what we would have to do. Now, can you just build corridors? Sandstorm. Always a sandstorm. I don't want to have to worry about it, so we're just going to call it now. See, if you go to the small, to the outside ones, you can actually build just a base pad, which you can use to expand the base. It'll fit into a lot of spaces. It's basically meant as a bridge, so that you don't have to stick these things right next to each other. You can stick one of these down. Like, if I wanted to expand over here, it won't let me do that, unfortunately, to get over this hump. Which it totally should, in my opinion. Come on, 4 times. Anyway, if I want to expand in this direction, I think the way to go first is to build another canteen. It's still close enough to this canteen to where it won't matter. It won't be a problem. Build a canteen. You'll have to wait, though, because we have a sandstorm coming. Okay, well, helping the accident victims did increase our prestige by 15. I can't help but think that if we had saved them all, it would have... Okay, we could have waited for that. It would have done more. We're gonna recycle this. I'm feeling good about it, guys. We've got our robots. We've got two more milestones. I'm gonna check to see if we can get the net. If we can start a base at the new place. If not, I'm probably gonna go ahead and just try and build the monolith. Hello, trade ship. You showed up during the sandstorm, which is probably a stupid idea. You don't have any blueprints, so I don't care about you. So yeah. Dang, that's a lot of metal. That storage. I wish we could customize storages. That's one thing I want to be able to do. I want to be able to say this storage is only for metal, this storage is only for bioplastic, or this storage is only for metal and bioplastic, and then stick it right next to these things. Or this storage is only for medical supplies, stick it near the clinic. This storage is only for vegetables and meat, stick it near the biodomes and the canteens. You know what I'm saying? Being able to manually specify what can go in what storage would be awesome. It would be very awesome. Come on, Sandstorm. We don't care about you. We don't want you anymore. This has been like a very angry episode, I feel. He's armed. We have armed guards. Not very many armed guards. We need like, what, 25 armed guards to get police state? Wait, where's police state? I know I saw one earlier. There was some sort of milestone for having tons of armed guards running around. I swear there was. Come on, Sandstorm, go away. There, Sandstorm's gone. So yeah, that was good. We got a couple of milestones today, which was excellent. So hopefully I'll be able to start a base on the ice planet, or is it a moon? It's a moon, an icy moon. Well, one of our robots got irreversibly damaged, but thankfully we got the milestone before it happened. Planning these bases is tough. Planning for future expansions. Basically, I've noticed a couple of trends here. What you want to do is, this is a terrible setup, having all of these small biodomes. Is really stupid. Just have one big biodome. This big biodome can hold the same amount of crops as all of these small ones in far smaller of a space. That's basically how this game works. Use fewer larger buildings rather than more small buildings. Okay, let's make some tables and video screens. Okay, so we want to make meal makers in here. We're gonna put those right here. And I want two of them. Two meal makers here. I want large tables. I can't put more than one large table per section. Two. As a matter of fact, we're gonna get rid of this meal maker. Don't put the meal makers there, because they're taking up space that needs to be used for these large tables. So we're putting four large tables. That's the most we can fit. Actually, we can't fit any meal makers in here now. Okay. So we need to put in three large tables, and then we're going to place two meal makers as you come in, which makes sense to me. Then we're going to place drinking fountains, obviously. We can place quite a few of them near the meal makers. We're going to place one there, and we're going to place one there for now. So that's those. Then we're going to put a couple of vid screens in, because we need a couple of vid screens. You know, people need their news. I'm gonna put those there. And then we're gonna put some decorative plants in, because we can't fit anything else over here. Excellent. That canteen will use up a ton of bioplastic, but there we go. So, I hope you guys have enjoyed this. I'm really hoping that we've unlocked the next planet so that in the next episode, we'll keep this around, but for the next episode, we can go ahead and start a base on that new planet so that we can take a look at the more difficult landing zones for this game. So, I'm still enjoying Planet Base. I hope you are, even though, you know, viewership of this series is kind of declining. And if I'm quite honest, YouTube's algorithms are probably punishing me for keeping this series going, but I enjoy it, and that's what I started this channel to do, the things that I enjoy. Which is why, if you want to help support me in a real way, consider becoming a patron, because I'll be honest with you, the patrons are the only reason that this is still happening, that the channel is still going, because YouTube doesn't pay anything. So anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this. Stay tuned for future episodes. Let me know in the comments what you want to see in future episodes. You know, I always want to engage with you guys. Reading your comments is one of my favorite parts of my day. I'm SentinalH, and I'm signing out.